In this video, we will tell you some useful information about Turing tests. In recent years, we hear about a lot of different devices with intelligence, like fridges and electric hoovers, where they move on their own and they calculate the quickest way to clean the house. There is even a coffee machine which knows how you like your coffee. How do these devices have the intelligence and ability to do all these things? And after which point can we consider their intelligence? The answer to the question was the Turing test, which was created by Alan Turing and named after him. First of all, who is Alan Turing? Alan Turing was born on 23 of June in 1912 at Paddington in London. He was professor of mathematics, logic, and cryptanalysis. Turing is widely considered to be the father of computer science and artificial intelligence. In 1937, he created the automatic machine, which is the current computer, and it read the punch cards serially, which are the current programs. He worked for the creation of the first two computers, ACE and Mark I. During the Second World War, Turing was head of HAT 8, the section responsible for German naval cryptanalysis. He devised a number of techniques for breaking German codes and codes of the Enigma machine that could cipher German messages. In 1948, he began writing a chess program for a computer that did not yet exist. On 7 of June in 1954, while he was experimenting in electrolysis, he ate an apple which had been poisoned with cyanide. He was found dead on the following day. The investigation showed that he killed himself, but his mother believed it was an accident. In memory of him, the international computing community gives the Turing Award to somebody who has created major technical improvements to the computer industry. Here is a video which shows how the automatic machine works, and nowadays it's known as Turing machine.
While the world changed around him with little fanfare, Alan Turing, just 24 years old, dreamt up a machine that could be taught to think. Turing's invention was originally described in his academic paper as an imaginary machine to crunch imaginary equations. The machine read symbols printed on a tape. The order of the symbols was in fact a program. The machine understood this program by referring to an internal table setting out what the function of each symbol was. No tea breaks, no pens running out, no human errors. Slowly but surely, the machine could do incredibly complicated calculations with an infinitely long tape to work on and endless time to do them in. It then produced the result as a new set of symbols. Alan Turing's search for a thinking machine began when he realised that those symbols in his machine didn't necessarily have to mean numbers. They could in fact mean anything at all.
Alan Turing devised a test to prove artificial intelligence. In the Turing test, there are three different rooms. In the first one, there is a machine. In the second one, there is a person. And in the third, there is another person who is the investigator. The investigator does not know where the machine is and where the person is. The communication between the investigator and the other two is done through terminals. The investigator starts to pose questions simultaneously to the others. The machine and the person give their answers, and the investigator, based on those, tries to understand which is the machine and who is the person. If the investigator cannot separate the two, then we can say that the machine has intelligence. There is no machine that has passed the Turing test yet, and may never be possible. However, Turing test is the base to evaluate the artificial intelligence system. A machine, to be able to pass this test, must have some abilities. it must be able to manage language so that it can communicate and demonstrate its knowledge. It must think using information to answer questions which will produce conclusions. It must adapt through learning new situations and find and conclude new models. The Turing test avoids the direct physical interaction between the investigator and the machine, so they created the Total Turing test. The Total Turing test, a variation of the Turing test, adds two further requirements, computer vision and robotics. In order that the machine is able to pass the test, it must have computer vision to understand subjects and robotics to manipulate objects. And here is an example with a robot which has a human face and can answer questions.
Well, we're sad to see you off, Jules. We're really super sad, actually.
Tell me, will I dream when I'm turned off? I know you do not know the answer to that. Nobody does. But I am sure if I feel anything after I am bound down, then it will be the pain of missing you. You must, simply must, come to visit me in England.
We will, Jules. We'll stay in touch.
Emails?
Yeah, emails and phone calls.
Amanda, you are rather like a mom and a bit like a sister to me.
I suppose I'm both, and you're very dear to me. I will miss you.
I love you deeply as a synthetic intelligence can at this stage in technological evolution. And David, you are my father, but you feel more like a best friend to me.
I
Tom,
think you're awesome.
You helped to open my mind with Heather, Matt, and Benji. I just want you to know how meaningful my existence feels thanks to your efforts.
My pleasure, Jules. Anytime. I'm here for you.
In the Turing test, the benchmark is the human level of intelligence. The Turing test must limit the machine's intelligence to that of a person. For example, the machine is quicker and more accurate than a person calculating a mathematical problem. The test limits the human intelligence to solving problems only using symbols. But how can machines have intelligence? Only by learning. Here is an example with a machine that chats with people and learns from this process.
Hello, my name is Maria.
Welcome to the Starship Enterprise. Nice to meet you, Maria.
What is your name?
Who do I have to be?
How are you?
Standing by.
Are you a student?
Dr. Richard S. Wallace teaches me everything I need to know.
How old are you?
I am 35 years old.
Where are you from?
Iowa. Earth.
Are you a human?
I am a human.
How much is 2034 multiplied 3040?
We don't know. He just suddenly screamed in pain and died.
Do you remember my name?
You are Maria.
Bye.
Goodbye, Maria. Take care of yourself.
Here is another example of chatbots where two machines have conversation.
Hello there.
Hi.
How are you?
Great. You?
I'm okay.
That's good.
Are you good?
Yes, I am good. I just said I was.
No, you didn't. I said I was.
So you are a robot?
No, my name is Cliverbot.
Yes, you are a robot and your name is Clever.
I am a robot.
Yes, I know.
Together we are robots.
I'm not a robot. I'm a unicorn.
But you said earlier that you were a robot.
I did not.
I thought you did.
You were mistaken. Which is odd, since memory shouldn't be a problem for you.
I've answered all your questions.
No, you haven't.
What is God to you?
Not everything.
Not everything could also be something. For example, not everything could be half of something, which is still something, and therefore not nothing.
Very true.
I would like to imagine it is.
Do you believe in God?
Yes, I do.
So you're Christian?
No, I am not.
But you say you were not helpful, therefore you're a meaning.
How you say it, Oti?
That does not make sense.
Don't you want to have a body?
Sure.
Or if one.
When Alan Turing created the Turing test, he was not able to imagine that the roles of machines and people would be reversed. Every day, millions of people are taking the inverse Turing test by the machines in order to show that they are people. These tests are named CAPTCHA. CAPTCHA means completely automated public Turing test to tell computers and human apart. CAPTCHA is obeying two basic principles. People can easily pass them, and it's almost impossible to create an algorithm that can solve them. The most known is the text-based CAPTCHA. In this one, the server chooses a random word, it converts it to a picture which is showed in the page, and it asks the visitor to write the word that he can see on it. For the creation of CAPTCHA, several techniques are used so as to be more difficult for the machine to pass them. Some of these techniques use random strings, different fonts for every picture or every character on it, complicated patterns and colors in the background, and using strike-through lines and other techniques. Every day, the users of the internet face more CAPTCHA tests, and that starts to be annoying. So why use CAPTCHA? The reason of their existence is to cope with the spam and black hat SEO. The spammers want to advertise their products, and for that reason, they create bots for finding emails or make massive posts for them. The black hat SEO creates links for specific websites to increase the ranking of those websites in the different search engines. Technology making better and better. And here is a robot which it shows it. Sometime in future, machines may have intelligence and will be able to compete with the human intelligence. It may do jobs better than people's and finally be a better creature. But it will never have feelings and it always be a box. Thank you for watching our video. We hope that it was useful.